而驱动 AI 应用的当然是 AI 晶片，这也是美国华尔街和科技界最热的企业，而龙头就是辉达。辉达的股价几乎已经是一年前的三倍，今年呢才过了一半，市场预估它很快会取代苹果，将来可能成为仅次于微软市值全球第二高的公司。辉达的执行长黄仁勋在6月3号这一天接受了 TVBS 看板人物的独家专访，畅谈他对于未来人类生活的愿景。他也透露了辉达将会在台湾盖一个研发中心，未来五年需要招聘在地1000名工程师。老赞，My name is Georgina。
魅力席卷全台的大忙人辉达执行长黄仁勋笑说，现在自己生活每30秒都被别人安排好。3号接受 TVBS 主持人方念华独家专访，揭开他对未来人类生活的想象。他说100年后的今天，人形机器人将无所不在，就像今天的汽车一样普遍，甚至可能成为世界上产量最大的机械系统。不过未来制造和技术将是两大关键。
Well, the world needs a lot more manufacturing capability. The number of manufacturers in the world is quite low. Labor force is quite short. And as a result, we're going to continue to see inflation. There are many things that a robot can make that no humans can make or safely make. And so there are things that only robots should build. And so I think it's very clear that we need to have robotics technology. The challenge, of course, is the technology itself is incredibly hard.
黄仁勋说，过去软体可以由软体工程师在笔电上写出来，但现在的 AI 人工智慧软体必须有超级电脑做强力后盾。辉达将来台设立全亚洲首座研发中心，要建立全台最大 AI 超级电脑 Taipei One。
I'm a huge fan of the company, the industry here, because it goes back with us for a very long time. That's a good foundation. But Taiwan is the source of so much of our engineering, and we have hundreds of engineers here, and over the next 5 years we're going to hire another 1,000 engineers here, and so we're going to set up our R&D center here, a major R&D center here.
黄仁勋表示，台湾的科技生态系统独一无二，从制造晶片到组装电脑，每一个环节都有。未来除了将在台招聘1000名工程师，他也公开喊话要找地盖厂。
We're seeking for a large plot of land so that we can build a significant headquarters here.
Okay.
And so if anybody has some property they'd like to tell me about, you know, please let me know.
而近来股价一飞冲天的辉达，市场预估很快将超越苹果，成为全球市值第二高的公司。过去一年，辉达股价飙上近三倍，达2.68兆美元。上周甚至带动美股纳斯达克指数首度站上17000点，因为几乎所有 AI 应用都仰赖辉达的高阶晶片。这也让辉达在2024年成为市值从1兆成长到2兆美元最快的企业。黄仁勋的身价也跟着水涨船高，不过他说对他而言并没有什么改变。
Absolutely nothing. I was trying to think of a good answer, but I still wake up the same time. I still work the same way. I ate the same things. I love all the same things. I love all the same people. Nobody treat me any different.And I still have a mountain of work in front of me. And so nothing has changed.
黄仁勋说，这其实是辉达和他自己的好习惯之一。
Irrespective of adversity or failure, I pick up and go back to work the next day just the same way.
顺势而为，趁势而起，黄仁勋就这样带领辉达在全世界雄霸一方。不过被媒体誉为三兆男的他，来台的另类焦点却是他穿梭台湾夜市尝遍美食的身影。连92岁的台积电创办人张忠谋都忍不住跟着黄仁勋来逛人生首次夜市。
I think it was Morris's first time at the night market.
Really?
Yeah.
So how did you persuade him to go there?
He wanted to go. And we had oyster fried pancakes, and we had some shaved ice. Two great places, and He really enjoyed it, and mostly we just enjoy each other's company.
对夜市有着儿时美好回忆的黄仁勋，对台湾也有着同样深厚的情感。如今61岁的他，将继续站在全球 AI 浪潮尖端，也将引领与辉达合作1/4个世纪的台湾开创新局。TVBS 综合报道。